Home sweet home. Oh, crikey, seriously? Hello?
Daniel, it's me, Etienne. Hey, we've got a bit of a major emergency going on here.
Oh, you're joking. Friday evening, and there's an emergency?
This is serious business. Sebastian Husher is nowhere to be found, and his manuscript should have been at the office by Tuesday. He won't answer his calls, and he hasn't shown up at his office at the university. He's vanished into thin air.
Oh, don't screw with me, Etienne. Call him on Monday or send a courier for him. I just got in the door less than 5 minutes ago.
I go myself, but I've got to attend Albert's performance in half an hour. Plus, Husher's house is closer to your place than it is to mine. Come on, man. The sooner you go, the sooner you'll get back home.
You're going to owe me a big fat favor.
Whatever you want. Write this down. 4 Abbott Thomas Road, in the old housing developments along Highway EB-15.
EB-15? Good God, that's out in the sticks! I plan to take a few days off after this.
Well, we'll talk about that once you find him. Oh, and if he gives you the manuscript, don't show it to anyone. And don't go selling it off to the highest bidder.
I'll see what I can do. We'll ring you up when I get back.
Thanks, Dan. You're saving my skin.
Again. Another Friday evening and I'm working as an errand boy. I suppose they're too important over at Wake Publishers to come looking for jolly old Husher themselves. Shit. Even I should be too important for that. Though I mustn't overstretch my complaints. Rising from my lot as a drunkard and financial ruin to that of an errand boy is actually quite an improvement. If only things had gone a bit better for the company. Or I'd got on the wagon a bit sooner. Damn, Sophie did the right thing when she divorced me. I would have divorced myself in her place. Daniel Neuer, a bloody alcoholic. Chin up, you. That is Daniel Neuer, the bloody ex-alcoholic, after all. Wake Publishers employee by day, Wake Publishers screwed over lackey by evening. Even Friday evenings. But if I could find Husher, I have a feeling my status at the company would rise quite a bit. After all, he is the publishing firm's biggest star. Let's cross our fingers and hope he's home. Hello? Is that music? I'd better take a look. Is that someone playing a music box? No, the music isn't coming from upstairs. There's something on that doorknob. Interesting. What the? How can there be a door there? Hardly taken a step forward when I heard the door close behind me. When I turned around, the door wasn't there anymore, and all that was left of it was a strange shadow on the wall. I searched, I despaired, and I screamed until my throat began to burn. The candles started to run out, as did the batteries in my torch. From within the most suffocating darkness, the hours went by, until turning into days, and I began to fall in and out of a restless sleep. I would hear voices, sometimes right next to me, other times a few yards away. It seemed like they were coming from the other side of the wall. Desperate cries, howling in horror, and sometimes, the worst of all, a vast, oppressive silence would fall, seeming to emanate from everywhere and nowhere all at once. There was nobody there, just hallucinations, nightmares, black nothingness, and the song from that music box. Trapped in this impossible place, I wondered if I was going to die there.
Etienne, do you have any news on Daniel yet?
Oh, Sophie. No. We've been calling him at home all day, but there's no response. Do you know if he's got a mobile phone?
No, I don't think so. And if he does, he doesn't tend to keep it on him.
Oh, man. I think I should pass by the Husher place when I leave, just to see if they know anything.
Husher the writer? Your client?
Yeah. I sent Daniel over there on Friday, and I haven't heard from him since.
What's the address? I'm going to stop by Daniel's place, and if I don't find him, I can go around and ask about him.
The house on the outskirts of town, on Highway EB-15. Number 4, Abbott Thomas Road. It's a big house.
Okay. I'm headed over. Call me if you find him.
Of course. Same to you.
I'm
Why is the front door open? not gonna happen. There's something on the counter. Okay. I need to check out what that noise was. must be someone in the house. I should take a look on this floor first. Hello? Who is this? I can't understand a thing. What is this?
We can't leave my room.
How the... What in the hell? It sounded like a child. Was that Husher's son? Thank you. Not gonna happen. Daniel? Is that you? What? What just happened? Am I going crazy?
Thank you.
Totally dark in there. Excellent. This should make things easier. I gotta hide here. Bloody hell! What in the world is happening inside this house? Mm-hmm. Not gonna happen.
What? Mrs. Husher?
I need to get in there. Thank you. That door almost knocked me out.
Thank you. started sleeping in Sol's room with the children. She's been avoiding me lately. Is she ashamed or something? Alexander and I have lived in this house for 16 years, with her and Mr. Sebastian. We've seen the children grow since they were babies. I don't understand this sudden change in attitude. I saw her playing and reading with the children in the living room last night. They looked exhausted. I could hear it in their voices, but they wouldn't go to sleep. They seemed to be avoiding it at all costs. I had a terrible nightmare last night. Something was lurking in the house. But in my attempt to escape, I couldn't find the main door. It was as if it didn't exist, or as if I couldn't make it to the entrance hall. The strangest thing is that I don't remember waking up.
the house.
Oh, fuck. I gotta hide. Just happened.
Starting to worry. A few days ago, Mrs. Catherine started sleeping in Sol's room.
Mommy's really scared. I'm scared too. She's broken all the mirrors in the house. And that song? We'd never listen to it. Something is watching us.
There's something.
Thank you.
help! God damn! Thank God I got it shut. Let's see what's up there. Julia? Are you all right? What? What's this? Where is she gone? Damn it, Daniel, you're gonna kill me. Mrs. Husher, are you here? None of this makes sense. Thank you. Nope. Not gonna happen.
What?
What?
Into the window.
I gotta go somewhere else. Nothing here. I gotta go somewhere else. Just happened. need some help down here.
They finally found me. I was feverish, dehydrated, and terrified. But alive. I don't remember much about the ride to the hospital, but I did mumble a few questions about the music box. I had heard it. The endless, grim song it played wouldn't stop hammering in my brain. I would even swear I'd seen it there on the table, on the other side of the mirror. No. No. Impossible. There was no box. It was just a hallucination. A mirage. I needed to rest. That was all. Just rest.